This piece I've brought in with me today is part of my Captain Hook costume. So everything that you see here is handmade. It's made of a base of buckram, which is a really commonly used hat making material that you can wet mould or steam mould. It's got a lot of wire in it. I've done a lot of stitch detail on the inside because I love some metallic stitching just for flair. I just love hat making. It's one small project that you can do in a smallish amount of time between other jobs, and it's just luxurious goodness.
So I've bought in my bodice, which is all hand embroidered. There's easily 100 hours worth of embroidery. We've got a whole lot of different types of stitches going into it. There was a lot of research, a lot of trial and error. It was a lot of fun.
This costume here was my own design. I always wanted to do my own tie armor, and this is made out of warbler. Obviously, like, it's cool thermal plastic that you can like heat form. It's nice and light and nice and durable as well. I made this about maybe 2 years ago now. Yeah, it's good fun. As you like, it's always a dream to have a tie armor, and now I've got one.
Some of my favourite costumes that I've ever created just to wear would be Radagast the Brown from The Hobbit, because you can do so much with him being within it. You've got fake noses, bird poop on your head, you're wearing crazy robes, and you can just be a character. My favourite costume that I've made because of the make of it is probably one of my most recent ones, which is my Captain Hook. It was a fabric stash challenge, so I tried to make it entirely out of what I had inside my house. I spent $30 finishing it. It's my favorite piece at the moment.
People ask for a time, what's your favorite costume you work on? But it's always the latest one. I did Nova, you know, from the Marvel Universe. That's the latest one I did this year. It's the first time I tried lights and stuff, so it's quite cool.
I love princessing. I love seeing the face of a child when they come up to me and they look at me and they're like, oh my god, you're Princess Fiona. And they are so excited to see you. In that moment, you're not, like, I'm not Rhiannon in that moment. I am trying to embody who that child thinks I am by just being a princess. And it's really fun. And it's quite wholesome, I find, as well.
Right now, myself, Victoria and Johanna, we are working on a Overwatch cosplay competition against Australia. So we are Team New Zealand, and we're making the Reaper Rainbow. It's like a Chinese New Year skin that they launched last year.
Sanit is our team leader. He got me and Johanna on board for our specialties. So he knows that I work really well with fabrics and pattern making and bits and pieces. So he got me on board to complement his armour making. And then we both got Johanna on board. She's amazing at many, many things, specifically leatherwork, but also she's doing our lighting and rigging and just some really cool other pieces that complement our armor and fabric work.
Big phrase that a lot of us cosplayers use is cosplay is not consent. We are human. We are not dolls for you to play and pull and touch without consent. Absolutely no different to taking photos randomly of people on the street versus randomly taking photos of somebody who's in costume, you ask. Good thing Armageddon has started doing is the massive signs that say cosplay is not consent. And they literally talks about what you should and shouldn't do on those signs. There has been some extreme cases. We've had problems with individuals overstepping boundaries, problems with people being too touchy-feely. There's definitely been people who have been removed from the community for violating community guidelines that we hold for our community. And I mean, like I said, there's people who have been thrown out of Armageddons because of their behavior, be it public or part of the cosplay community themselves. We've got a lot of very talented people in such a small community. There's a wealth of absolute talent of people that are over here. I think Kiwi ingenuity definitely offsets us from the rest.